In this video, you're going to learn how to maximize the performance of your spinning reel by managing the amount of line you have on the reel. This is all about how much line should I put on the reel, right? What's the appropriate amount? What's the gap? So this is very important. This often gets overlooked, and it can cause a lot of trouble if you don't do it properly. If you put too much line on, you're going to significantly increase the odds of getting wind knots. And if you put too little line on, you're not going to be able to cast nearly as far, and that's going to decrease the amount of fish you catch. That is also bad as well. And so what I'll do is we'll talk about the ideal situation, and also I'll show you a trick on how to manage your line, how to know exactly how much backing to put on so that, you know, 150-yard spool will fit just right. All right, so let's start with the gap, right? What is the gap? So the gap, this is very important. This is the gap in between the edge of your spool and the outer layer of your line. How much gap is there? You obviously want to have some gap, otherwise the line is just going to be all shooting off at once and you're going to get wind knots. But if the gap is too large, you're going to decrease the amount of distance you can cast, because, you know, how this works, this line is obviously coming off the spool, and the longer distance it has to travel to go up and around this spool, right, the top of the spool, that is going to decrease your casting. So what's the appropriate amount? I've seen a lot of recommendations for an eighth of an inch, and that's basically where this is. So, and I want to say, yes, that definitely does work, right? It certainly will cast pretty far, and this is actually just under an eighth of an inch. So this is what I've seen a lot of recommendations applied, but it definitely, you know, does work. It does cast pretty far, and your wind knots are going to be very, I would say, a low likelihood. But what I found is when there's this much gap, the casting distance is just compromised. And so what I've started doing is going to less gap. So here's kind of a comparison on kind of the before and after. So what I do now is like this reel over here on the right, this is much less gap. This is now, instead of an eighth, it's more like a 16th. It's actually even probably a little bit less than a 16th. Let's go ahead and measure it. So we'll measure it, and the gap there, if you can see, hopefully there's not a shadow, but it's just under a 16th of an inch. And so what I'm finding is that I'm casting much further with this gap, with this smaller gap, than I am with a larger one. But just know that there is going to be an elevated risk of wind knots. So you have to be a little bit careful if you're casting into a strong wind. But what I found is that even with this little gap, I really haven't been having issues. And between these two gaps, there's a noticeable difference in casting performance. So just keep that in mind. When you are spooling up your reels, I would recommend at least giving it a try to this little bit less gap. Worst case, right, you get a wind knot, you cut it out, and now you're back to square one. And as far as the trick in spooling and how to maximize the amount of line you get on there, how to know exactly how much backing you put on your reel before you put on, say, a 150-yard spool of line, is that this is the distance. So a quarter inch is what I found for most 2,500 to 3,000 size reels. Obviously, different brands have different size reels. For example, the one on my left, this black one, is a Shimano. This is a 3,000 size Shimano. The one on the right is a 2,500 size Daiwa. This is the Procyon, Daiwa Procyon, Shimano Stratic, and the diameters are pretty much the same. So just know that when you go from brand to brand, it's gonna be a little bit different. And so what I found when spooling up this 150-yard spool, right, for just maximizing this where I can get almost it perfect every time, is that for a 3,000 to 2,500 size reel, a quarter inch gap is what's needed with the backing. So get that, tie the line to line, and it's gonna come out almost perfect every time, right? It's never gonna be exactly right, but you can get it really close. And what you're definitely not gonna end up is a situation where you use your 150-yard line and now you have too much of a gap and there's really nothing you can do. You pretty much have to waste the line or pull it off, and it's a huge hassle. So just to be safe, right, quarter inch gap for the typical size 2,500 to 3,000 size spool. Let me just go ahead and give you a measurement of it, so in case you're using something different. So this is about 1¾ inches as far as the diameter of the spool. And again, for that situation with a 10-pound braid that's 0.15 millimeters, a quarter inch gap is what you need. Obviously, if you're going to be using a thicker or thinner line or a bigger or smaller diameter reel, do the math. It's, you know, just kind of guesstimate and at least get you rolling in the right direction. But so far, I've been pleasantly surprised. I've done this with different reels from Shimano, from Daiwa, from Pin, and it seems to be getting very, very accurate results, and has certainly helped me save a ton of time and hassle when spooling up the gear. So I hope that helps. This is basically the before and after, right? Before with the quarter inch gap, after with the 1/16 gap. If you have any questions at all, leave a comment down below. I'd love to help out any way. And if you found anything different when you've been testing out lines, you know, please let us know. This is all about a forever learning thing. That's the cool thing about fishing is we never know it all. And it's all about just sharing tips and tactics with each other. So use the comment section down below. We love to hear from you. And if you're new to Salt Strong, just know that we're the best online fishing club in America because we actually guarantee you'll be catching more fish while saving time and money. We do this through our premium education, our exclusive insider community, and huge discounts on all the tackle you need. To learn more, go to saltstrong.com. Otherwise, hope to see you again soon.